another hit for Devin Haney. That's what it looks like. Today was the purse bid for his fight with Sandor Martin, and the only company bidding was Top Rank, who are some of the best in the business when it comes to boxing. They know their stuff. They've been around forever. And they bid $2.4 million on this fight. And the way it breaks down, a 70-30 split with like $200,000, $275,000 going to the winner, being held for the winner. So Haney will get paid $1.5 million. As the champion, as the guy who claims to be the face of boxing, as the guy who claims to be that this is his era, $1.5 million for anybody is amazing money. And Sandor Martin is making over $600,000. $1.5 million for a fight? But now any fight is very tough for Haney. Any fight is very, very challenging. So Haney writes, I should have bid myself. Well, why not? He has a promotion company. He should have. So Top Rank bid. The bid was not very high. It was good for Top Rank. Good deal. Their fighter, Sandor Martin, has a chance right now to become a world champion. And Devin Haney, he's not pleased with this. And I can't blame him. But then again, he is not the draw he says he is. He does not sell pay-per-views. This fight will probably not be a pay-per-view fight. So that is just the reality of boxing and the reality of it. So you could say Top Rank were the only bidders. Eddie Hearn, Dan Raphael reports that he did not like this fight, and therefore he did not really bid on it. And Devin Haney, as you saw, he was posted. He was surprised that Mashroom didn't bid on the fight. But if you're coming off a loss to Ryan and your two last two fights, there wasn't really a big pay-per-view sale. It didn't sell. And the gates weren't very good. And Sandor Martin is not the biggest name. He's from Spain. And maybe they do the fight in Spain. It's going to be amazing. But the fight may not be in Spain. It's going to be a hard sell. And pay-per-view is not pay-per-view. So it's regular TV. So in conclusion, the Devin Haney era ended when he lost to Ryan Garcia. I don't think it ever started. But this is just another sign that he is not the next Floyd Mayweather. Again, $1.5 million is not bad money, but if he's expecting to make $35 million, $40 million, $100 million as a champion. So a lot of reports that he may just vacate the title and then Top Rank could have their guys fight for it at 140. They have Teofimo, they have Ray Muratai at 35 who can move up. They have so many fighters, Keyshawn Davis, they have a lot of fighters. Shakur, he stays with Top Rank. Maybe, you know, there's a lot of options over there regarding this fight. So we'll keep you guys posted. But right now, Devin Haney is very surprised that his purse bid went for so low. And Top Rank were the only ones bidding for it. Sandor Martin is the best position either way. Either makes $500,000 or he fights for the title in any event. So let's see if Haney vacates the title or not. We'll keep you guys posted. But what do you think? The purse bid for $2.4 million with 70-30 split for the champion, Devin the Dream Haney. Some fighters make like $1.5 million just on a sponsorship. So if he revved up his sponsorship, I saw he was posting stuff like shout outs on his page for some money, like $250 or $750, whatever it was, $750. So he could do some shout outs for his fight and make a little more and maybe find other ways to balance the money. But he needs a tune-up or two anyways after that Ryan Garcia fight, because if he fights anybody legit, anybody dangerous, anyone that's a puncher, Devin is in deep trouble. Ryan Garcia was maybe 10% of his ability in that fight. He didn't train, he partied, he was in Vegas a week before the fight. He was doing a lot of stuff the fighter should not be doing, and he still beat Devin. All this talk about the cheating, not cheating, the amounts that were found in the system was so low, did not affect his performance, and that could have been a mistake the way he ingested it. Well, I don't believe Ryan's a cheater, but I believe Haney got exposed, and I believe the world got to see that Devin Haney is not the boxing genius that they sold us. He doesn't have the high boxing IQ. He doesn't have any power. He's hitting Ryan on the back. Ryan said his three-year-old daughter hits harder, and he doesn't have defense, and he doesn't know how to adjust, and once he got clipped, he didn't even get dropped in the first round. It was over. So that's what we learned about Devin Haney from the Ryan fight. And Ryan wants to fight Virgil Ortiz. He's very serious about it. Does it happen next? We don't know. I asked Virgil yesterday. Virgil says, I believe the fight will happen, but not next. And Virgil also says they only fought twice in the amateurs, not three times. So maybe Ryan's confused and he's concerned, as in he's referring that this third fight will be a third fight now that they fought three times. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. But Devin Haney's stock at an all-time low. literally 1.5 million for his next fight. For a guy who claimed that his last fight he made 35 million, that's a huge pay cut. But that's like normal. To be honest with you guys, it's normal in boxing. When you lose, you get paid your minimum. And 1.5 minimum is actually pretty good, because his minimum could have been $10,000 or $60,000 or $50,000. I know fighters that have fought for $500,000, lost, and then they fought for $50,000. That's their minimum. But Devin's his own promoter, so he could have bid on this, and he could have put on the show. So I'm not sure why he didn't. I have an idea why he wasn't bidding. He was too busy bragging about a sparring session from ages ago that no one cares about. That sparring session with Tank is old news right now, because Tank is the face of boxing. Tank is the pound-for-pound king, coming off 30-0, 28 knockouts, where Devin lost to Ryan Garcia, who Tank already beat. So the sparring session is irrelevant. I've seen Manny Pacquiao many times not do great in sparring, but do great in the ring. I've seen many fighters do that. Sparring and fighting is two different things. And if you're bragging about sparring, then you're a gym fighter. That's what it is. Because I know fighters who look like killers in the gym, but they're not killers in real life. It's just not hating. I'm just saying it the way it is. Everybody's different. So we'll keep you guys posted. But there you have it. Devin Haney should have bid on himself. But then again, he may not have the money he says he does. I saw the comments where people said with the cars was a rental day or whatever. Even if it is his cars, you can't spend all that money and think you're going to make every day big pays. And I don't think with Ryan, I don't know what he made, but I don't think it's $35 million. Logically, rationally, how could it be $35 million when the pay-per-view numbers were never released? Whether it was $250 or $350, I think it was $250. His pay-per-view with Regis was over, what, $30,000, $50,000? We don't even know. Extremely low. And the gate, the event wasn't sold out. There were tons of empty seats. So it's just hard to believe that that fight brought in numbers like that for him. Anything's possible, but I doubt it. Seriously, seriously doubt it. Especially when they announced that the whole gate was only $4 million. So there you have it, guys. We'll keep you guys posted. But Devin Haney, let's see what's next. Does he vacate? Does he do a tune-up? Does he take this fight? We'll know in the next few days. We'll keep you guys posted. FaceNewsReporting.com and Melvin Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting.